Black.
Who put this one here? Get the event planner. How do you want to do it? There's a problem. What other problem coming up?
Thank you.
Very good morning.
You arouse this in the interest of the people who have come to this place. Of a truth, it looks like we have come to mourn, but we have come to celebrate a life well lived. And so the musicians, please, wherever you are, entertain this audience. If you are not ready, you tell us that we are not ready.
Get you ready to mount to the bandstand. Thank you.
Your seat.
Okay.
Give this burial ceremony a befitting one. You will do it. If the burial will be a befitting one, you are going to do it. So please, stop going around. Don't be creating unseen movement. A lot of things are going on. We don't want it to be going that way. Thank you. Please, the choir is going.
Oh!
me, follow me.
And the devil who deceived them was thrown into the lake of burning sulfur, where the beast and the false prophet have been thrown. They will be tormented day and night forever and ever. Then I saw a great white, and he was seated. The earth and the heaven fled from his presence, and there was no place for them. And I saw the dead, great and small, standing before the throne. Books were open. Another book, which is the book of life. The dead were judged according to what they had done, as recorded in the books. The sea gave that it, and death and give up the dead that we are, and each person was judged according to what he had done. The dead and we are to the leg, yeah, the leg. Another, anyone, thank you. Anyone, the reading of his word in the house in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you and God bless you.
Others, then, maybe one person. Thank you and God bless you. We are waiting for you. If you come to this place, you tell us who you are and the relationship with this family. Thank you.
Ihe ọ na-akọwa maka ndị na-anụ bekee na-anwụ a ga-agụpụta tribute ugbu a. Onye ọbụla ga-agụpụta ya ga-eme ka anyị mata ebe nke o si abịa, ofu onye ga-esi n'ezinụlọ, ofu onye ga-esi na ebe ndị enyi dịka ị na-abịa, mee ka anyị mara onye ịbụ, ka enye gị ohere. Nke ahụ a ga-ewe oge anyị biko. Ok, ọ dị onye na-abịa nụ si otu a nwanyị nwa.
Ọchịchọ sorrow ha mee Jesus oke. Ihe sorrow ha mee Jesus.
Ama nkwụ ụmụ zọmbọ ihe Chiọwa Arụchukwu Local Government of Abia State. Mama was the only surviving child of her mother. Late Rose Orihe Kalunjasi was devoted her time to giving Mama a moral and spiritual upbringing. Although Mama did not receive hard work, discipline, confidence was installed in Mama at an early age. Qualities that no doubt caught the attention of late husband. Marriage and family life. Deaconess Jemima got married at a tender age, as was with the tradition of that time, to a loving, hardworking, and supporting husband. The late Chief Mbanto of Ndeje, the same compound with Mama. As a result, she was called Mwanadia. The seeming lie that Mama might not be able to bear children, since her mother gave birth to her after 50 years of marriage, did not doubt Papa. Fortunately, and to the glory of God, Mama born him 9 children, 3 males and 6 females, all still alive and healthy today, to the glory of God. Mama had had four children here in Nigeria, and the last 5 in Cameroon, where she located with her husband. Being hardworking, Mama settled in the quickly adjusted to life in Cameroon, very protected of her children, grand and great-grandchildren. She was a very courageous, determined, and fearless woman who always stood against any injustice towards her family. Mama was known to be very outspoken, and most times Mama was known to be hardworking from her youth. Up until her sudden death, She was managed whatever she had to feed the family. To us, Mama made miracles in those early hard times because she made something out of almost nothing for the family upkeep. She was entirely until her last days and would go to the farm against and wishes, and even she had paid for higher level. Ezinne Jemima was a very remarkable woman who was blessed with good health all through her life. She was really sick even at old age, and her visit to the hospital were merely for routine checkup. Mama desired and most times did everything for herself because she never wanted to become a burden or source of trouble to anyone. Age grade. Mama age grade was on her weekend. They ruled from the year 1990 to 1997 for 7 years as our tradition requires. On her weekend age grade during their time, build a teacher's quarters in then the St. Patrick's School, Omozombo, now Omozombo Community Primary School, and donated to the community. Mama was a very strong member whose ideas and support contributed immensely to the success of their age grade. Mama, with her age grade, retired officially from community service in 1997. Religious life. Deaconess Jemima Mba in the early days was formerly called Meke Orihe. She later on joined the Apostolic Church with her husband and was Christian's Jemima. From then, Mama became a dedicated, devoted Christian. She never misses morning prayers in the church, and Sunday service was very dear to her and her absolute must. Mama never eats before going to the church, a routine she kept till her death. Mama was wise and very prayerful. She interceded constantly for every member of the family.
condolence. I write to condole with you and your family most profoundly on the transition of your beloved mother, late Ezinne Nicholas Jumaima Wanladia Mba Utol, who died at the age of 90 years. Your late mother, from available record, lived and died being a good woman and a caring mother. She served God and humanity selflessly, positively inspired, and transformed many lives. Therefore, I urge you and others mourning this loss to be consoled by the fact that she lived a good and fulfilled life and depicted sterling legacies. As you prepare for the burial today, 29th October 2021, here in Omuzomo Ihechioma, Arochukwu Local Government of Abia State, I pray God to grant her soul eternal rest as her body remains and laid to rest, and give you all the fortitude to bear this irreparable loss. Signed, Senator Dr. Joseph Okalu, MOA, Chief Whip of the Senate, Federal Republic of Nigeria. Thank you.
God bless you. Bless you. Thank you, sister. You're welcome. At this time, is an important hour.
And after God rejected the sacrifice, he told his brother, can we go outside? And his brother followed him. Then he began to retract his steps. Took an object and hit the brother. Both there and then Abel died. And he covered it up. I returned home and said nothing happened. After that time, nobody had died before. I don't even know how he got the idea that he could kill his brother. God called him and said, Ken, where is my
brother?
And Ken had the effrontery.
Ken, where he came?
Am I my brother's keeper? From that time, death began to come into the world. Listen to me. Many people are dying these days. Some are dying as a result of greed. Some are dying as a result of wickedness. Some are dying as a result of lust. Some are dying as a result as a result of envy. Some are being assassinated by others. Death came into the world and passed on to every man, because every man has sinned. The Bible says, for all of sin are falling short of the glory of God. By birth we are sinners. By action we are sinners. By character we are sinners. Right from our birth, we are born in sin. When we grow up, we begin to practice it. That is why all of us, in a matter of time, we shall die. It was in a gathering like this that the casket was brought in. And my little child, it was one elder John that was in the casket. And my little child knew of that elder. Immediately the coffin was brought into the field. My little child asked me, is elder John in that box?
Oh, okay, John. Daddy, underneath me, what?
Hello.
When you look at him,
he said, "Is ever John in that box?"
Open my John. Say, okay, John. Away underneath me, what?
Today,
ta.
Our mother is in that box.
Mom, yeah, underneath me, what?
I don't know what you may refer to that box.
I'm not going to see underneath me, what?
Whether you would call it the last box,
underneath me,
whether you call it self-contained,
But
look at it there.
Malaya never.
That is the central lesson for all of us
here.
As we look at that casket,
we remind
ourselves that one day, it may be on a Monday,
it may be on a Tuesday.
Not be here. It is not a cause, it is a reality. As we all seated here, looking at that casket, we are indirectly looking at ourselves. That one day, we will lie like this. You might feel strong now. You might feel energetic now. You might feel healthy now.
And
it got nothing to do with it. The Bible says, it is appointed unto man
that
wants to die. It is appointed unto man. It is a divine appointment. You might be in London. You might be in Nigeria. You might be in the hospital. You
might
be surrounded by the best doctors. The Bible says, it is appointed unto me. Once to die. It is an appointment. Nobody will fight it back. The moment it comes, it has come. There is no coming back. The Bible tells us that now that we are living, it is time to prepare for eternity. There is nothing important about this world than human beings. And there is nothing important about human beings but their soul. Jesus said, what shall it profit a man if he gains the whole world and lose his own soul? Can I tell you something today? It is not possible to own all the houses on one street. I said it is not possible to have all the houses on one street. Every effort to achieve that is vanity. The Bible tells us, what shall it profit a man if he goes in home? I lose his own soul. I don't know what you're looking at.
Here.
I don't know what you're looking at here. I don't know what you're thinking about.
Here.
I don't know how you are wishing yourself. If I could get this, if my house could be like this, if I could drive this kind of car,
but
let me tell you something. It goes beyond that. The Bible says, he is appointed unto man once to die, and after that, the judgment. May I remind you, that in God's judgment, there is no defense. In that vision, he said, I saw the day. I saw the day. Small and great stand before God. And I'm telling us today that in that vision, you are there.
You are
there. I am there. The nonentities, the morons, the elements, the covenants, the idea. And I hope you are ready. The Bible says, prepare to meet your God. It might be today. It might be tomorrow. After death comes judgment. The Bible says, it is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. And after judgment, there will come eternity. There is heaven. There is hell. It got nothing to do with what you believe. There is heaven. There is hell. The moment you close your eyes in this world, it will be like catapulting.
You will find yourself in another abode. You will find yourself in another world. It is a transition. Death is the variable that carries us
away.
Once it comes, comes to you, you will go in. Jesus said,
Jesus will say,
behold, I stand at the door.
That was a man also.
And knock.
Knock.
If any man opens
the door,
I will come in.
Where man was about that?
And so put him.
But I will let you leave glory.
A story was told of a Nigerian soldier.
Oh, my God, provide it. Oh, yeah, oh, yeah, oh, yeah, oh, yeah, Nigeria.
He was newly wedded.
Oh, my God, oh, my God.
And when the list came out for us to go to Liberia on a peace mission, his name was on the list. Tears rolled down his eyes. He put his arm on the wife. He said, this is what I signed. God will keep you. And God will keep me.
Okay.
So we can see again.
Okay.
And the man joined the plane and left.
Okay.
In the battlefront, where they are fighting, any little space, he switched to a corner. Says God, remember
my voice.
Went back to the
work.
He was sending the salary directly to the wife. While the wife was enjoying at home, he was risking his life on the battlefield. After his time had expired,
they
were to come back to Nigeria. So the plane flew them from Monrovia to Lagos. He and his colleagues. His colleagues were rushing to the hotel room to spend money. He took a little money in his pocket and went to buy gifts for the wife. He refused to go into the hotel. He had a lonely to see the wife. Please tell your neighbor beside you, somebody is knocking on the door. Open the door by half.
I
said she opened the door by half. And with her body, she occupied the space, the little space that she opened. And the man rushed to embrace her with joy. And she just dipped like this. And the man, with all the gifts she behind him, and the man said, what is the matter? Are you not happy that I came back alive? While the man was asking that question, from the top of her shoulder, the man sighted a man on the bed. And the man said, is it because of that man in there that you refuse to open the door
for me?
Please, can you be on your feet?
Ahiwe Apostle Didi Achibong Apostle M. K. Carlo Apostle Iro Anya Emmanuel Apostle, I mean Prophet M.K. Carlo, am I right? E.K. Carlo and Apostle Bruno, Apostle B.U. Uche. Stand up as you. Apostle M.A. Apostle Marcus M.A. Okay, let me give to one of them. Okay, okay, let me obey from the biggest man.
Hallelujah! Onobiola, you are blessed.
Please, all the ministers of the gospel, you are welcome. May the Lord bless you. All the elders here, may the Lord bless you.
Amen.
Every member of the Apostolic Church, may the Lord bless you. I wouldn't want anybody to kill you. I've mentioned my name. Nobody will come to a great highness. I know him. He's a personal friend. His Royal Highness, Eze Linto, and he knows his friends. And so I want to greet you alone, sir. I don't know the others. May the Lord Almighty console you, comfort you, give you the fortitude to bear this loss. It's not the one who says it's irreparable. Mama has gone to be with the Lord. So we shall meet with her. Thank you very much, Eze.
Right about now, it is time for the interment. The time is far-fetched and we are doing everything humanly possible to make sure we live here on time.
I don't understand what you are doing.
Interment,
are you interrupting?
No, interment is the next step, but for now, the offertory, please, sir.
Help yourself. We don't do this. Help yourself. Well.
I'm gonna see you, I'm gonna never be. Majesties and Highnesses, the bankers, the Sovereign Dealers Association, worldwide, our nation, and the bank. My in-laws from Igbo, Tigrisi,
I've handed him over to his security man. Please, no man is...
Sure. We're set very well.
Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever believeth in me shall never die. For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worms destroy my body, yet in my flesh shall I see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and not another. Brethren, we brought nothing into
Jesus name, do your son. You know, I've ever been bleating on, we'll pick our God. Find you the blood of Jesus to sanctify this girl. Now recognize this son, and the music in our own chain. God, I will not dig a more bullet, or mad or jaw bullet. Gege wuri huwa anya we yonyo bude na ha Jesus
amen
inka kaine de anzo bana han ken
amen
ko para
amen
ke monso
amen
And I want you to think about yourself and think about how you came to the world. If you don't know, this is the end of your presence in the world. But remember that what you have done on earth goes with you. And that is where the blessing of the service of Mama Jemima comes in here. That she has served the Lord faithfully and given her life. I know her very well. She was all about the duty and works of the Lord. And it is our belief and observation strictly that Mama, with her husband, continued to raise the children until the husband left. Mama carried on to raise his children and make them great men and great women. Today, she is being honored as we lay down her body to the earth from where she was made. But let us remember that we believe that she has gone to be with the Lord in heaven. So shall every one of us face the world like this. And think about yourself. You might be lowered, but not to be lifted to heaven. Mama, with her services, is being lowered. And when the trumpet shall come, we are most assured that she will be lifted from this ground to meet the Lord God Almighty. And there her tears shall be wiped away. I want you to believe in Christ. Unless you do that, you may not enter into the kingdom of the Lord. Remove the rope and let us, do the rest.
My rest in the Lord.
Is this the hand? Of hell and of death, they shall hunger no more, neither thirst anymore, neither shall the sun lift on them, light on them, nor any heat. For the Lamb which is in the midst of the throne shall feed them and shall lead them into the living fountains of waters. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. I know whom I believe. And I'm persuaded that he is able to keep that which I've committed unto him against that day. The Lord. Now are we the sons of God, and it doth not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. For as much as it has pleased the Lord God Almighty in his great mercy to take unto himself the soul of my dearly beloved mother, Deaconess, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, in sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord, who shall fashion anew our body of humiliation, that it may be conformed to the body of his glory. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead which die in Christ from henceforth. Yea, said the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, and their works do follow them. Shall we pray? Father, unto you we give glory and honor from everlasting to ever, continue to be with your church and to bless us. As we go after this, Lord, may all roads obey your command. Amen. To keep the travelers safely to their homes.
Amen.
And protect His Royal Highness and His family as we leave them here.
Amen.
Father, let it be so.
Amen.
And so, Lord, thank you for everything.
You.
In the name of the Father,
amen,
and of the Son,
amen,
and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord of God, the Father, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with you all, now and forevermore.
Amen.
The Lord will do wonders among us.
The Lord
will do wonders among us.
The Lord
will do wonders for me. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you in Jesus' name. I shall be covered. Thank you very much.
Do not let the enemies, O Lord Jehovah, overwhelm your children. Mother,
protect us. Let your prayer continue. Let your prayer continue. We know you are in the bosom of the Lord. The Lord will grant us peace. The Lord must grant us love. Lord, unity, we pray to our family. Mommy, unite us anywhere you are. Unite us anywhere we are. Unite us anywhere you are. Unite us. You have always been a peaceful mother. The Lord knows it best. Mommy, go well. Open way for your children. Grant us financial strength. Protect us, mother. Pray to God that you should always protect your children and guide us well. That we must have unity among us. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Mommy, go well. Mommy, go well.
Chief Joachim.
My
brother, as you know, who's on the Anya from Ebe, Msibia. Here, book Ram Nemesh America, Lower.
Of all the effort in the future, and I make a lot of prayer. His Royal Highness is a Larus to her in a very special way. Oh, Fuma, carry 1 million children, even though I had in mind, he distinguishes himself as a son, any man, anywhere. So wish they had any man, any woman. More about the role they play in the family. I know how jealous he is of his mother, how protective he has always been. And all that love has been poured out. Everybody in this family have looked forward to this day. They have each contributed their quota. It is in Bakara is the way. So Mama is here very well. During these last 2 days or three, I'm a Hebasarana. Oh, you'll be a mouth when you want. You made them. Why you want more Nania, a fool, I'm very happy, proud. The way my relationship is, I'm all over the world.
Can I speak in English? My name is Rosemary Mwogo, and I'm the seventh child of this amazing woman that we just buried today. I have much to say, but even if I start a whole day, I can't finish. But I can say she's a virtuous woman. We will wish she could live for another 90 years if the Lord permits, but unfortunately, the Lord wants it this one. She was a spiritual lady. She cared for us. She prayed for us every single day. My mom was a blessing to this family. She's the matriarch that keeps everything together. She's bold. She's not afraid to say her mind to anybody. She speaks the truth. When you're wrong, she questions you. I can't even. This is so difficult. But she's my voice of strength, and I'm sure I can speak for my siblings. My mother is my voice of strength. And I'm trying, I'm finding it very difficult. All I can do is hold on to those values that my mom is still in me. My mom always tells me, she says, don't worry about your troubles. Don't worry about your troubles, worry about today. Take care of yourself, take care of your children. Be strong no matter what the situation is. So even when I'm dealing with the worst, when I talk to my mom, she makes everything better because her advice is always on top. Whatever she says, I do it, and I feel like my world is better. So with that, all I can do is hang on to this value that she's instilled in me. So right now, I just have to walk with them. But I know she's watching over us. She got her wings, and I know every step I take, she's right behind me. She's on my side. She's in front of me. So I have no fear.
Lola, thank you. I know very sure that there are lots of people that came here, other from the same Imo State.
Yes.
To sympathize with you. What I have to tell them?
Oh, I am so grateful. Thank God that everybody made it here safely. And I pray to God that they make it back home safely in Jesus' name. I just can't thank them. They are blessing. I love them. And I can't wait to go back home to be safe. And at least maybe spend 1 or 2 days with them. God bless you all.
Thank you. Lola, God bless you. I think I'm going to put it up. I think it's going on the list.
Bless you, bless me, my boy. It is even good that you both of you want to do it at the same time. Can we keep falling for you? No, no, but push it. Can we keep bullet Solomon, King Solomon, Uncle? All the way from Mbisi, Echeta, Ewecheta, Wecheta, all the way from Mbisi, Ndoko, Dalono, for coming. Choose one of the left. 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 Thank you very much. Okay, they are still there. Okay, go ahead. I'm a honey, 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 okay, you won't be there and tell me what to do. I cover this podium with a mouth. I cover you, I cover you, I cover you. The man is still there. So once he leaves, he will stop it. Let him finish every day there. Okay, we're bending Kashi. Is your goal? Thank you. All the way from UBC, God bless you. God bless you so richly. Thank you very much. Doga in MBC, thank you. God bless you. Yeah. Doga in from MBC, thank you. Is he from Cross River? Is he from Cross River? From where? From Cross River State. You would have allowed me to usher you in or to invite you. But now you are not to perform. I have people on the stage that are gonna perform for us now. Iban, King Solomon, God bless you. Take us to the next one.
Yeah. Champions will win our day.
Please, let's respect home, respect. Come. They don't explain for themselves, you never see. This one I just see through. Mommy, God bless you. This money remains. Oh, yeah, and say, okay, yeah. All the way from UBC, I'm a halfway group. Go to your head, group. Oh,
Thank you.